Hi folks, Melvin here from OptoProductions.com. I've been using and teaching Ableton Live for several years now. And this one thing always bothered me. And that's when you record something with monitoring set to auto or input, your recordings are delayed by a certain amount. As you can see, the recording is way later than the MIDI. Like if you zoom in and I turn off the grid, as you can see at the bottom of the screen, it's delayed by 34 milliseconds. Of course, I'm using a large buffer size right now. If I decrease the buffer size, as you can see, the buffer doesn't really affect the latency. But what does affect the latency is the monitoring. If I set it to off, now the latency is almost gone. The difference is night and day. So according to Ableton, this behavior is implemented because when you're playing guitar or recording any other instrument in real time, you're automatically compensating for the latency yourself. So when you hear yourself back a bit delayed, you play slightly early, so it still sounds in time. However, if you're sending out MIDI from Ableton to a hardware synth, this doesn't make sense at all. So before Ableton 12, you either had to use direct monitoring on your audio interface, or you needed to create an additional track, like I've got right here, and then record on a track with input monitoring set to off. And then you can use the other track to hear what you're doing. So if I record it again, you can see I can still hear the sound, but I don't get the latency. Okay, so now with Ableton 12, there's this new feature that isn't really advertised. If you activate the mixer right here and you press the arrow button, you can show the track options. And here you can see, in addition to track delay, there's now a keep latency option. By default it's turned on, but if you turn it off for the audio track, and I've got input monitoring either set to in or auto, and now if I press record, now you can see the latency is gone, even though we had input monitoring set to auto. So on this track, when keep latency is turned off, Ableton will compensate for the latency difference. When it's turned on, it won't. Even if we add plugins, so if I take a really CPU intensive plugin, T-Click for example, if you hover your mouse over the plugin, you can see, whoa, the latency is 600 milliseconds. If I copy these plugins to the second track and we record both again, the bottom track is delayed like, well, half a second. But the amount of plugins don't matter, because right here keep latency is turned off. So if we listen, look at the amount of latency. It's insane. So yeah, now you can record synths without latency while still listening to the effects. Okay, let me also quickly explain one thing, and that is often misunderstood, and that's the driver error compensation. And as you can see, Ableton automatically detects the latency over here, the overall latency. So that's the sound going into your computer and back out again. That's the overall latency you hear. Many people think that they have to compensate for the latency by setting the driver error compensation to a negative value, so it ends up at 0 milliseconds. But this is not the case. As long as you have delay compensation turned on in the menu over here, Ableton will automatically compensate for this delay. Driver error compensation is only there in case your interface isn't reporting the right values. And there's actually a useful Ableton lesson if you go to Help, Built-in Lessons, and you scroll down to Show all built-in lessons. At the bottom we can find driver error compensation. If you go through all the steps in this lesson, you can properly set up your driver error compensation. So in my case, it was only set to about half a millisecond. So that's not really noticeable in most cases. But yeah, even with driver error compensation set and with keep latency turned off, it's still possible you're still getting some latency. And this is one thing Ableton can't really fix for us. And that's MIDI latency. Each hardware device and MIDI interface also needs some time to process information. So whether you use 5-pin MIDI connections or USB MIDI, There's always a slight delay between transmitting MIDI and receiving audio. So this really depends on the MIDI interface you're using. If I take a look in my situation. Okay, so I've recorded a couple takes, and if I zoom in really closely, you can also zoom in the waveform now with Ableton 12. And as you can see, it's really a tiny little offset. If I turn off the grid, it's, what is it, 3 milliseconds? Yeah, it's shown at the bottom of the screen. 3 milliseconds. So that's the latency I'm getting right now. And the only way to fix this is to open up the mixer again. And we need to set the track delay, in this case on the MIDI track. So I'm getting a latency of 3 milliseconds. And on the MIDI track, I now want to set a negative value of 3 milliseconds. Let's record that again. Ah, as you can see, it's actually a bit too early now. So I would have to fine-tune this. I can even fine-tune it in samples. But yeah, you have to set this by trial and error, because Ableton really doesn't show the selection length in samples. But yeah, let's tweak it a little bit, maybe minus 120 samples. Still a bit early. Let's try minus 100. Right, so yeah, now I can basically get it spot on. It takes some time to tweak this. And it also depends on which output you're using. It depends on if you're chaining multiple MIDI devices. So the more devices you add to a single MIDI chain, the more latency you will get. But yeah, of course, you can just save this in your template. Go to File, Save Live Set as Template. And then you can set this value for each MIDI output. But yeah, that's basically it. Life just got a little bit easier with Ableton 12. So I hope this video gave you some insights into this whole MIDI latency issue. There's still some manual adjustments you need to do, but I guess that's just life. Let me know if you have any questions. Check out the Electronic Music Studio Facebook group to learn more about hardware and electronic music production. And I'll see you next week with another tutorial.